and welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be all about why you shouldn't rely on income just from social media in 2019. So I feel like a lot of people these days are pushing the social media lifestyle. Obviously, it's such a huge thing and a part of all of our lives, and a lot of people are making very good money from being very present on social media and using the sites to the best of their advantage. I do want to talk about today just a few ways why you shouldn't rely on income from purely just social media platforms, because I think there's a lot of misconceptions that these days you can become a YouTube star or you can become big on Instagram and just make all the money and then your career is set, which I don't really believe is the case, and I know a lot of other people out there are under the same impression too. So I want to explain a little bit why especially I don't rely on social media income. I think I talked about this a little bit in my last video about using social media in terms of passive income. So I definitely think that's a way that people should be making money these days and should be definitely aiming for, because it is good to have several revenue streams, especially if you are a freelancer and you feel like you might need to rely on a few different things to keep you going with consistency of money. I do feel that social media is a little bit tricky at times though, and I'm going to go through a few reasons why I think you shouldn't rely on it just purely. The first reason I think you shouldn't rely on social media for income is because websites and social media platforms can change constantly. I think most people would probably remember Adpocalypse on YouTube, and that did affect a lot of people's way of earning money, and it really did affect their livelihoods, because this is where they were getting most of their income from, and then suddenly one day it wasn't there anymore. And for a lot of people, they did suffer from that apocalypse. And that's just a really good example of how quickly social media platforms can change. Even the fact that Instagram is looking towards taking away their like function on images, that could potentially be a factor in some people maybe not getting as much attention on the imagery. We just don't know at this point, because a lot of it can be psychological. In terms of looking at likes, sometimes you can feel like you need to like something because there's already got so many likes, and you kind of fall into the trap of not necessarily thinking for yourself and thinking that the image must be great because it has so many likes. I think it will introduce a lot more critical thinking into users' minds on Instagram and in terms of how they view photos on there, which I think is a good thing to an extent. I think it's a really good thing. But I think in that case, for a lot of people that are on Instagram and that is their main source of income, whether it be for sponsorships or advertising, it's a very tricky thing if something gets changed on the platform itself, how that can affect your income, and you're not as much in control of your own income. And that's the second point that I want to make, is the fact that you want to be in control of your own income. And basically, having all of your income coming from social media sites, I guess it's very much like having an employer in a lot of ways, or being at a full-time job, except there's not as much security there. And I think that as soon as something changes, you don't have the option to change it back, or you don't have the option to basically save yourself from falling into that trap. So I think it's nice to have that control over your income and know that no matter what, you're going to have some form of income coming in that is yours, that it's yours and it's not going to be changed by any social media platform. Point number three is actually another fact that can arise with a lot of different social media platforms, and that people that are relying on social media for income are actually not maximizing their potential to earn from it. So say if I was to basically rely on AdSense every month, and a lot of people are in the same position as me, they wouldn't get very far with their income. Unfortunately, it's not always the best option to say, okay, I just want to be a YouTuber, or I just want to be an Instagrammer. Like I said previously in the video, things can change at any time. And I do feel like there are so many other ways and different revenue streams that you can capitalize on to make your income bigger and better. And I think a lot of those ways are just different to using purely social media to earn AdSense or to earn things from sponsorships. I think there's got to be something else going on, or a few other revenue streams that you say to yourself, okay, this is what I'm in control of, or this is what I'm going to earn from this month, not necessarily just from a social media platform. I think there's got to be definitely a few different options out there for you if social media is a big part of your income. But I think that's another reason probably why you shouldn't rely on it, is that there's other ways to really maximize your potential with earnings. There's also the inconsistency that comes along with social media earnings. So, I mean, with YouTube, I think the longer that you're on there, sometimes it can become a little bit more consistent, but it's different for every person. And as said previously, things can change at any time. Particularly if one of your videos or a few of your videos don't do well in a month, then you could be getting thousands of dollars less or hundreds of dollars less than what you usually would be, and then suddenly that does become a problem. So it's very inconsistent in that way that you don't ever really know how much you're going to be earning per month. And I mean, that's really just part of being a freelancer. Like, I think a lot of people just have to suck that up, and that is unfortunately a negative that comes along with freelancing. But it's something to be very wary of with social media, and knowing that you don't necessarily have 100% what you're going to earn in the month, and you don't know for sure. And the last point I want to make is that sometimes I think a lot of people struggle with stepping away from social media and feeling like they can't step away from social media because it in turn becomes their job and their livelihood, and they feel like they need to be glued to their computer screens. And as much as that can be part of anyone's job these days with social media, I think people that are purely focused on social media income really struggle with that fact at times. I do feel like that's another issue that a lot of people struggle with, is especially like stepping away from social media when they need to. So guys, I hope those points have made sense to you as to why you maybe shouldn't just rely on a social media income. I would say the main platforms for relying on social media tend to come from YouTube and Instagram a lot of the time, but I think it's really something to be aware of. Like, social media is an amazing thing. It's an amazing tool, and I would recommend anyone that ever has a business these days to get on top of it and to really have a presence online and on social media. But there's got to be other ways of being a little bit more in control of your income in terms of having your own website, having your own blog, having things that are your own and that you can control and how well they're doing. Things like YouTube, that's a little bit harder to do in terms of income. So I do find that social media can be a bit fickle when it comes to earning from it. But as long as you keep those things in mind, I think most people can have a very lucrative and successful time on social media whilst also focusing on other things that can help them earn a very good income. So thanks guys so much for watching, and I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you would like me to do more videos like this in terms of the business realm of freelancing or photography, please let me know, as I'd love to do more of them in future. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, and please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and click the notification bell so you see all the videos that I will have out there in the future. Thanks guys for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.